Hello, my name's Mark and this is Dice Tales, and it's stopped raining, so I'm recording again, if you might have caught my earlier upload. So anyway, Star Wars Legion tonight, and it is a hyperlapse, so I'm going to try and slow it down and talk over it, and then I'm just going to do the photos of the highlights at the end of that. And then if you really want to see all the photos that I took of the game, they are going to be in the blog post below. And also I've linked to the 14 pocket sleeves that I have, and the coin capsule disc tokens, they are in the blog below as well. So let's get to the game. Let's see, it's a Tatooine based game. It is Han and Chewie versus General Vaz and his two Imperial Walkers. The story so far is it's Tatooine base, some sort of Rebel Nexus upload center, so it's key position. So I've got three buildings. The Rebels want to defend these buildings, upload their data, and get the hell out of there before Vaz and the might of the Imperial Navy come down on them. So let's go see what happens on the game. Okay, so there are the coin capsules and the black 14 pocket organisers that I have for my game. And we're just laying out for deployment. So it's the L-shape advanced positions, and troopers can do a speed 1 movement. So most of my guys move up behind that bell tower building in the middle. So let's name the buildings. We've got the squat single dome building, that's one key position. The bell tower in the middle, which is another key position, and you can't quite see it just off the camera. There's a biscuit barrel squat two-story building, but you can't get on the roof, and that is the third key position. So I have a trooper on the biscuit barrel. I move my troopers up and into the bell tower, and he's going to do the same on the squat building here, and he's placed two Imperial Walkers on the left and the right flank. I've got a fleet trooper behind the two-tone building, the two-domed building, and a rotary cannon ATRT. I've got three ATRTs, two with a rotary cannon and one with a flamer. The flamer one is unpainted, going at the middle there. On the first turn, I misplay my orders a little bit. We probably could have got away with no shots, but I moved my flamer up first when I should have moved one of the other walkers, and he brings his walker in and takes it out. He wins the initiative on the second turn and takes out the walker. So my revenge is on the left there, my fleet troopers coming around the corner with concussion grenades and a scatter gun, and they blow away a complete stormtrooper unit. Very happy with that. Right, can't see what I'm doing behind that building, but basically Chewie's climbed the bell tower and I've got a unit on the balcony. And there's also a squad of core troopers with a repair bot and an iron cannon directly behind the bell tower that we can't see. You can just see peeking out another core unit holding the biscuit barrel objective for me. Basically moves up and he's firing mortars and laser cannons at me from both directions. My biscuit barrel team move forward to try and get their guns to bear. I didn't want them just idling, because if they idle, I'm just going to get chased down by Imperial Walkers, I think. But they do put in some use, because of his DLTs at range 4, they can actually reach, and his Imperial Walkers and the Stormtroopers on the roof have to take pot shots at them instead. Fortunately, they do get wiped out for this heroic action. But they pretty much save my walkers and the guys on the balcony at the front there. So, very useful tactic from Han. My walker on the left is coming to hassle Vaz a little bit. He retrogrades that move, he tries to move back and walk into my walker, but he has no impact on his legs, so we let him take that move back. Instead he walks forward onto my iron cannon core unit of troops. I'm moving up, taking pot shots at anything on the roof I can. It's one of those difficult decisions where, do I shoot at something that's already shot to maybe take it out for the next turn, or shoot at something that I might be able to take out this turn so before it fires. So probably should take out, focus fire and take out something so it's not going to be there next turn. Might do that next game. It's quite heavy. It's heavy cover on that roof, no matter. He seems to be winning at this point because he's taken my guys off my balcony. Chewie's hanging on in there. He tried to use Guardian a few times. Probably saved one or two men. Get them on the balcony maybe one turn longer. And now he's going for full suppression on my fleet troopers because they're the only guys that can capture that squat building at this moment. Because my still got the iron group behind that bell tower, they're probably not going to last too much longer with that Imperial Walker. And Han has fled back to capture the what I'm calling the biscuit barrel key position. I think I missed, it's going a bit fast for me. He's been laying suppressive fire down on my fleet troops, and I think I've just played Turning the Tide, which means my vehicles have Inspiring 2, and they can take off two suppressions from my fleet troopers. So when it looked bleak and they were about to flee, that Turn of Tide and my two walkers being very close by manages to get them the edge where they can move up and be in position to move up onto the roof and take out Stormtrooper squad on pretty much the final turn, turn six. So now I'm contesting the key position on his side. Chewie's still alive in the central bell tower. He did think that Viz had a range 2 weapon, but I believe he's got a range 3 weapon. So he thinks he could have maybe taken sniper shots at Chewie in the bell tower a little bit earlier. But it wouldn't have mattered because that would have taken me off the middle one. Han would still have had the third key position. So I won with 2 points on that particular game. As I say, rethinking of Viz's range, maybe could have taken out Han if he'd moved positions a little bit sooner. Not taken out Chewie in the bell tower a little bit sooner. But that's because I had my fleet troopers managed to remove all the suppression on that final turn with Turn of Tide. That was a big turning point for me when I thought I was losing. That brought me back into the game on turn 5. Anyway, let's do the highlight pictures. So Han, on seeing the two Imperial Walkers coming to his base, suddenly gets a droopy gun. I've got to fix that later. This is my fleet troopers moving up on the first turn, and there's a squad of stormtroopers behind that double-domed building. So when he takes out my flame AT-RT on the first turn, they're going to move around and take their revenge. That was a good moment for me, I quite like that. As I say, they were men in the match as they kept moving up that left flank. Quite good saving throws, to be honest. Surge to save as well, which is why I like them. I'm really, really thinking of picking up a second fleet squad, to be honest. That's him taking out the flamer on the first turn. This is pretty much the match. It's rooftop warfare. So as I've mentioned, they're heavy cover on both buildings. And basically my rotary cannons were shooting up there from my ATRTs. Han and this balcony squad were shooting at them. Chewie, I keep saying Han. Han never really got shot off in the game at all. He middled around the middle and basically was giving Chewie dodge tokens, which was useful for his survival. And then one of the squads got taken off, as I mentioned, that biscuit barrel objective. He fled back to make sure I was still scoring that. It's quite a rotund building, so even if he did get his walkers on it, I think there could have been quite a merry-go-round going on if I'd not won the centre field. And there's my rotary cannons. Again, it was the decisions on do you shoot something to take it out? Do you shoot something to try and take it out so before it shoots this turn? I generally went for the second option, shoot it before it can shoot this turn. Which I think helps his DLTs. As I said, they had to shoot my distracting squad. And then the remaining stormtroopers couldn't really hurt my ATRTs without the impact of that bigger weapon and the bigger dice pool. So maybe I made the right decisions. We talked about maybe having Han going up and doing his pistol blasting, but I think he would have been too big a target with two Imperial Walkers bearing down on him, the suppression weapon bearing down on him. I think I made the right decisions in the game in respect to Han. View from his side, Viz cowering but giving out aim tokens to all his squad mates, and just sort of staying tucked in cover, I think out of line of sight of my fleet troopers and warp troop and ATRT when they're double moving up. Thinking that I might be able to distract a walker or draw some fire. He had lots of targets, ultimately. That was the aim of the game. This is him trying to crush with his feet my Blue Man Group squad with the Fixer Bot. The Fixer Bot did repair one damage on that ATRT there. So it did come in useful. What would I change? I can't think of what I'd change in this particular game, to be honest. It's quite a nice list. Chewie always sniping, but with his pierce he can pretty much always guarantee taking out one stormtrooper at least. And this is the flow of the game. So it was standing orders from both of us on the first turn. Did I mention it was limited visibility? That's why there were no shots fired on the first turn, other than that very close one. Then I played change of plans. He was planning something nasty with his Imperial Walkers, so he had to take that card back. But then he played a card where we matched initiative, and I lost that roll-off and lost my Flamer, as you remember. Reckless Diversion, my biscuit barrel building squad came forward. They were in range 4 of a lot of weapons. Really did their job, took a lot of suppression, and unfortunately perished because of it, but they gave all my other troopers a breather. What's that? Ambush, I think that was when I was getting stood on by the Imperial Walker. I managed to flee back, try and win the roll-off, and try and get an Ion. And the Ion just fizzled. I didn't roll very well. I think I only got one attack through, and he managed to save and throw. It was Turning the Tide, which was my big one. After he'd laid down about 5 suppression on those fleet troopers, they were ready to panic and run away on their next activation. However, Turning the Tide, I could take off 2 suppression tokens for each of the walkers. Now, Ham was only in range of 1, so you could only give an order to 1, and I really love that order pool, face-down order pool mechanic, where you don't know what you're going to draw, but I drew them in the right order. So the Rotary Cannons managed to pick off stormtroopers while inspiring my fleet troopers, who could then move into position to be able to capture that rooftop on the final turn when it was desperately needed. And I think that is about it, yeah. There's a fleet troopers on the roof, winning me the game. And back to the droopy pistol. Don't worry, Ham, we won the game. I'm sure we can rectify that situation soon with a bit of hot water. Okay, so that was my hyperlapse and highlights video. There are more photos in the blog link below. The rain has stopped, thankfully, so hopefully you can hear me now. I've played with my noise gate a little bit, and I'm sitting closer to the mic as people have recommended. So any other recommendations, I will take them on board. And Tabletop Legacy next weekend. So this game was played at The Forge, which is near the Trafford Centre. Steamforge Games, known for their Guild Ball. And next weekend there's a bit of an event going on called Tabletop Legacy. Another YouTuber, a big, very big YouTuber. And it's going to be all sorts of games there. I'm hoping to get in Gaslands, Vanguard, and maybe Star Wars Legion. And anyway, do hit us up on the forums for on Facebook for The Forge, Element Games, or Tabletop Legacy. And I will see you around. So thanks for that. I'm going to add this to the YouTube and replace the ring-noised one that I posted before. Thank you very much. Goodbye.